Good morning, and welcome to St. Patrick's Episcopal Church online worship service on this last Sunday after Pentecost, also designated as Christ the King Sunday, and here at St. Patrick's, our Harvest of Souls Sunday. We're located at 418 North Sapodilla Avenue in West Palm Beach, Florida. And because we are not able to gather together in our beautiful sanctuary due to the COVID-19 pandemic, we now offer this online service in order to fulfill our need for corporate worship. We thank you for being with us today, and we hope that when this crisis is over, you will join us in person at 9 a.m. on Sunday mornings. Our service begins in the Book of Common Prayer on page 355. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, and blessed be his kingdom, now and forever. Amen. The Collect for Purity. Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name through Christ our Lord. And now please join me as we recite together the Gloria. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, Heavenly King, Almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. And now our collect for this last Sunday after Pentecost. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Almighty and everlasting God, whose will it is to restore all things in your well-beloved Son, the King of Kings and Lord of Lords, mercifully grant that the peoples of the earth, divided and enslaved by sin, may be freed and brought together under his most gracious rule, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. And now our scripture readings for the day.
The first lesson is taken from Ezekiel chapter 34, verses 11 to 16 and 20 to 24. Thus says the Lord God, I myself will search for my sheep and will seek them out, as shepherds seek out their flocks when they are among their scattered sheep. So will I seek out my sheep. I will rescue them from all the places to which they have been scattered on a day of clouds and thick darkness. I will bring them out from the peoples and gather them from the countries, and will bring them into their own land, and I will feed them on the mountains of Israel, by the watercourses, and in all the inhabited parts of the land. I will feed them with good pasture, and the mountain heights of Israel shall be their pasture. There they shall lie down in good grazing land, and they shall feed on rich pasture of the mountains of Israel. I myself will be the shepherd of my sheep, and I will make them lie down, says the Lord God. I will seek the lost, and I will bring back the strayed. And I will build up the injured, and I will strengthen the weak, but the fat and the strong I will destroy. I will feed them with justice. Therefore, thus says the Lord God to them, I myself will judge between the fat sheep and the lean sheep. Because you pushed with flank and shoulder and butted all the weak animals with your horns, until you scattered them far and wide, I will save my flock, and they shall no longer be ravaged, and I will judge between sheep and sheep. I will set up over them one shepherd, my servant David, and he shall feed them. He shall feed them and be their shepherd. And I, the Lord, will be their God, and my servant David shall be prince among them. I, the Lord, have spoken. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let us read responsively from Psalms 100, verses 1 through 4. Be joyful in the Lord, all you lands. Serve the Lord with gladness and come before his presence with a song.
Know this, the Lord himself is God. He himself has made us, and we are his. We are his people, and the sheep of his pasture.
Enter his gates with thanksgiving. Go into his courts with praise. Give thanks to him and call upon his name.
For the Lord is good. His mercy is everlasting, and his faithfulness endures from age to age.
The second lesson is taken from the book of Ephesians, chapter 1, verses 15 through 23. I have heard of your faith in the Lord Jesus and your love toward all the saints. And for this reason, I do not cease to give thanks for you as I remember you in my prayers. I pray that the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, may give you a spirit of wisdom and revelation as you come to know him, so that, with the eyes of your heart enlightened, you may know what is the hope to which he has called you, what are the riches of his glorious inheritance among the saints, and what is the immeasurable greatness of his power for us who believe, according to the working of his great power. God put this power to work in Christ when he raised him from the dead and seated him at his right hand in the heavenly places, far above all rule and authority and power and dominion, and above every name that is named, not only in this age, but in the age to come. And he has put all things under his feet and has made him the head over all things for the church, which is his body, the fullness of him who fills all in all. This is the word of the Lord.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Matthew. Jesus said, "When the Son of Man comes in his glory and all the angels with him, then he will sit on the throne of his glory. All the nations will be gathered before him, and he will separate people one from another, as a shepherd separates the sheep from the goats. and he will put the sheep at his right hand and the goats at the left. Then the king will say to those at his right hand, come, you that are blessed by my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. For I was hungry and you gave me food. I was thirsty and you gave me something to drink. I was a stranger and you welcomed me. I was naked and you gave me clothing. I was sick and you took care of me. I was in prison and you visited me. Then the righteous will answer him, Lord, when was it that we saw you hungry and gave you food, or thirsty and gave you something to drink? And when was it that we saw you a stranger and welcomed you, or naked and gave you clothing? And when was it that we saw you sick or in prison and visited you? And the king will answer them, truly I tell you, just as you did it to one of the least of these who are members of my family, you did it to me. Then he will say to those at his left hand, you that are accursed, depart from me into the eternal fire prepared for the devil and his angels. For I was hungry, and you gave me no food. I was thirsty, and you gave me nothing to drink. I was a stranger, and you did not welcome me. Naked, and you did not give me clothing. Sick, and in prison, and you did not visit me. Then they will answer, Lord, when was it that we saw you hungry or thirsty, or a stranger, or naked, or sick, or in prison, and did not take care of you? Then he will answer them, truly I tell you, just as you did not do it to one of the least of these, you did not do it to me. And these will go away into eternal punishment, but the righteous enter eternal life. This is the gospel of our Lord.
In the name of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Are you feeling like you have a full plate and don't know quite where to start? That's how I feel with where we are today. We are 8 months into the COVID-19 pandemic. And while there is good news about possible vaccines, we are still not able to gather for corporate worship, and numbers here in Florida and across the nation are rising. Add to that the unsettled nature of our presidential election, which I pray will be resolved sooner rather than later. Oh, and have I mentioned a record hurricane season that has just done untold damage to life and property in our brothers and sisters in Central America? In our own little Episcopal world, we celebrate today the last Sunday after Pentecost, also designated as Christ the King Sunday, and we have our own celebration at St. Patrick's of the Harvest of Souls. If that's not enough, this coming Thursday is our National Thanksgiving Day, a holiday that is complicated by the pandemic and the decisions we have to make whether to actually gather together to give thanks with family and friends. As always, we turn to Holy Scripture in order to find our way through this host of issues, starting with the beautiful words of comfort from the book of Ezekiel. Thus says the Lord God, I myself will search for my sheep and seek them out. As shepherds seek out their flocks when they are among their scattered sheep, so I will seek out my sheep. I will rescue them from all the places to which they have been scattered. Ezekiel goes on to say that God will feed them on the mountains of Israel. They shall lie down in good grazing land. I will seek the lost and bring back the strayed, bind up the injured, and strengthen the weak. Oh, how we need to hear these words of comfort from God through the prophet Ezekiel. It reminds me that in spite of all that seems so overwhelming, I have much to be thankful for. We as a people have much to be thankful for. But this prophetic word is not just about God and how God will care for God's people. It is also about justice. God says, I will feed them justice, God's justice. This concept of justice runs throughout the Old and New Testaments. God is just, and God expects God's people to be just and to work for justice. It is not enough for me to say that God is just and not be willing to work for justice, to work to see that economic and legal systems are there to benefit everyone and that no one is put down or disadvantaged by injustice. Micah, another one of God's prophets, puts it this way. What does the Lord require of you but to do justice, to love mercy, and walk humbly with your God? Yes, God is just, and we must work with God to see that justice is manifested in our world. Our reading from Matthew's Gospel today highlights another part of Micah's words about loving mercy. Jesus is describing what will happen when the Son of Man comes and sits on his throne of glory. He will separate the sheep and the goats. The sheep he will invite to inherit the kingdom prepared from the foundations of the world. These, he said, are the folks who fed him when he was hungry, gave him something to drink when he was thirsty, those who welcomed the stranger, clothed the naked, and visited those who were sick and in prison. Strangely enough, these sheep don't even seem to know when they did these things. And so they ask Jesus, when did we do this to you? His reply, just as you did it to one of the least of these who are members of my family, you did it to me. The goat, on the other hand, are not invited into the kingdom because they did not feed him when he's hungry or give him drink when he was thirsty. They did not welcome the stranger or clothe the naked or comfort those sick and in prison. They also don't know when they didn't do these things. And Jesus replied to them, just as you did not do it to one of the least of these, you did not do it to me. It is important to note that these called the least of these are not necessarily our own kind. It is not enough for us to just show mercy to one another in our own circle of family and friends. There is no one who lives outside of God's family in God's eyes. It is also important to note that our worship and prayer and piety are not enough for us to be invited into the kingdom prepared before the foundation of time. Yes, those things are important and necessary, but God is also calling us to love kindness and to do justice. So in this world of ours turned upside down, let us continue to work for justice. Let us continue to feed the hungry and give drink to the thirsty. Let us clothe the naked. Let us welcome the stranger and visit those who are sick and in prison. In this way, we are serving the Son of Man and doing the work that God has called us to do. My prayer for all of us and for you, especially here at St. Patrick's, is that you may have a blessed and gratitude-filled Thanksgiving Day and holiday. And may God continue to bless our work for justice and mercy. Amen. Now let us confess our faith in the words of the Nicene Creed, page 358. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven by the power of the Holy Spirit. He became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Prayers of the People, Form 3, page 387. Father, we pray for your holy Catholic Church,
that we all may be one.
Grant that every member of the church may truly and humbly serve you,
that your name may be glorified by all people.
We pray for all bishops, priests, and deacons,
that they may be faithful ministers of your word and sacraments.
We pray for all who govern and hold authority in the nations of the world,
that there may be justice and peace on the earth.
Give us grace to do your will in all that we undertake,
that our works may find favor in your sight.
Have compassion on those who suffer from any grief or trouble,
that they may be delivered from their distress.
Give to the departed eternal rest.
Let light perpetual shine upon them.
We praise you for your saints who have entered into joy.
May we also come to share in your heavenly kingdom.
Let us pray for our own needs and those of others, those on our prayer roll, for those who are sick and shut-in, Rodolfo Perez, Catherine Ryan, Rudolph Stewart, Richard Jerry, Ted Martin, Herbert Earl Threets, Charlene Fox, Leroy Lashley, Holder Skinner, Gregory Belk, Andrea Peppers. Let us please turn to page 360 for the confession of sins. Together. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways, to the glory of your name. Amen.
Almighty God, have mercy on you, forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life. Amen. And now, may the peace of the Lord be always with you. And now, as our Savior Christ hath taught us, we are bold to pray. Because we are not actually able to take communion in these streamed services, we now offer this prayer for spiritual communion. Let us pray. In union, blessed Jesus, with the faithful gathered at every altar of your church, where your blessed body and blood are offered this day, and remembering particularly St. Patrick's Episcopal Church parish, its people, and those worshiping with us via this streamed service. We long to offer you praise and thanksgiving for creation and all the blessings of this life, for the redemption won for us by your life, death, and resurrection, for the means of grace, and for the hope of glory. We believe that you are truly present in the Holy Sacrament, and since we cannot at this time receive communion, we pray you to come into our hearts. We unite ourselves with you and embrace you with all our heart and soul and mind. Let nothing separate us from you. Let us serve you in this life until, by your grace, we come to your glorious kingdom and your unending peace. Amen. And the people respond.
Come, Lord Jesus, and dwell in my heart. In the fullness of your strength, be my wisdom and guide me in right pathways. Conform my life and actions to the image of your holiness, and in the power of your gracious might, rule over every hostile power that threatens or disturbs the growth of your kingdom, who with the Father and the Holy Spirit lives and reigns one God in glory everlasting. Amen.
Now let us pray our post-communion prayer together. Let us pray. Eternal God, Heavenly Father, you have graciously accepted us as living members of your Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, and you have fed us with spiritual food in the sacrament of his body and blood. Send us now into the world in peace, and grant us strength and courage to love and serve you with gladness and singleness of heart, through Christ our Lord. Amen. And now may the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you now and always. Amen.
So good. God is so prayer.
Thank you to our online viewers for tuning in and sharing in our worship service this day. And a thank you to Reverend Paul for sharing God's words to encourage and inspire us. This week, birthday blessings go out to Albert Archer and DeAndre Evans. So let's pray. Almighty and eternal God, grant to your servants as they begin another year your wisdom and grace, and strengthen their trust in your goodness. Watch over them as their days increase. Bless and guide them. Comfort them when discouraged and sorrowful, and raise them up when they fall. And may your peace, which passes all human understanding, abide in their heart all the days of their life, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Today is our Harvest of Souls service. It is a time we focus on harvest and thanksgiving to God for the bountiful blessings each one of us has been given. Our church is usually decorated with the fruit of the land in thanksgiving and in celebration of the National Day of Thanks that is here in a few days. It is also a time we raise funds for the Church of St. Patrick's. You should have received an email last week asking you to contact Keene Wilkinson as part of our fundraising effort. You were to form a team and provide Keene with the team's names, the members' names, and the goal that you are seeking. The winning team will be announced during this December 13th service. And you can still contact Keene if you have not yet done that. Keene can be reached at kpach01@aol.com. I'll repeat that. That's kpach01@aol.com if you have any questions or concerns. Thursday coming is the National Day of Giving Thanks, and COVID may have us staying in our home, unable to celebrate as we normally would. The church is not open, but Greg and I will lead morning prayer, a litany of thanks and prayers at 8 a.m. So tune in on Thursday morning and please join us and start the day off with God in thanksgiving. And this time of the year is normally a time that we do travel. So let us pray for those who will be traveling at this time. O God, our Heavenly Father, your glory fills the whole creation and your presence is found wherever we go. Bless all your saints and preserve those who travel. Surround them with your loving care. Protect them from every danger. Bring them in safety to their journey's end, and bring them back again safely to us, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. As the calendar year closes, we begin to think of our commitment to St. Patrick's Church for the year 2021. Your commitment card and more information will be coming shortly. But in the meantime, please meditate and pray about your commitment to the church and return the commitment cards to the office by December 6th. Thank you for tuning in and sharing our worship experience this week. And please tell and share the link to this online service with your family and friends. The virus is not slowing down, so stay home and help stop the spread of the virus. It saves lives, and if you must go out, wear your mask and practice social distancing. Have a blessed and joyous Thanksgiving Day. We are thankful for many things, but chiefly we are thankful for God, for without Him, we have nothing else to be thankful for. Remember, God is good all the time. All the time, God is good. Amen. Lord be with you. We have been watered, we have been fed, and now we are sent out to love. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.